Former Navy Chaplain Gordon James Klingenschmitt has been defending religious liberty across America, especially your right to pray publicly in Jesus' name. Operators are standing by to receive your calls, so please call the toll-free number on your screen or visit PrayInJesusName.org. Now with today's message, here's Chaplain Klingenschmitt.
And let me say, God bless you in Jesus' name. Can I say that here? Is this a Jesus crowd? You know, there are some places in America where it's literally becoming illegal to use the word Jesus in our public prayers. But first I want to say, I am Chaplain Gordon James Klingenschmitt. I was inspired by great men of faith before me, like Peter and John. You remember in Acts chapter 4, they were hauled before the Sanhedrin, and the Pharisees ordered them, "You will not preach or teach or anything at all in Jesus' name." And they said, "Who are you, Pharisees? Should we obey men or should we obey God?" And they kept on preaching and teaching in Jesus' name. They obeyed God and they disobeyed men, and they were flogged in Acts chapter 5, but they rejoiced that they were found worthy to share in Christ's suffering. Well, you would think if the Pharisees wanted to make Jesus an illegal word back 2,000 years ago, there's no way that could happen here in America today, right? Because we have the First Amendment. We have freedom of speech here in America. Well, I found otherwise. As a Navy chaplain, I fought for the right of all of my sailors to practice their own faith. My programs won awards. We fed the homeless, and we were named the best ship in the U.S. Navy for community service. But in 2006, the Secretary of the Navy wrote a bad policy, SecNav Instruction 1730.7C. He said that chaplains' prayers have to be what they call non-sectarian. In other words, don't pray in Jesus' name. Don't use the word Jesus because that might offend somebody. Oh, sure, you can pray in Jesus' name inside the Sunday chapel, but if you set one foot outside of the chapel, you better water down your prayers. Don't use the J word. And don't do it in uniform. And don't do it in public. And certainly, my commander said, don't do it in the presence of news media. I took advisement to this brand new Navy policy, as was explained by my supervisor at the time, Chaplain Norm Holcomb, who now, you know, he's a historical revisionist. He's trying to go back and say, oh no, Chaplain Klingenschmitt was never told that he could not pray in Jesus' name. In fact, the issue had nothing at all to do with prayer. He was just discharged for disobeying what they call a lawful order. But what I have here is Chaplain Holcomb back then, when he was my supervisor as a Navy chaplain. He directly told me that I could be punished for praying in Jesus' name, and I'll play that tape right now.
Chaplain, should you go pray this? Yes. Are you going to pray in Jesus' name? Yes, you can't pray. If you do go and pray in Jesus' name, you can be punished. Because it is the CO's call. It is the CO's call.
So if you couldn't hear that, he said, Chaplain Klingenschmitt, will you go pray? Yes. Are you going to pray in Jesus' name? Yes. Then you can't go. If you do go and you pray in Jesus' name, you can be punished because it is the CO's call. It is the CO's call. And that was how he explained SecNav Instruction 1730.7C, this bad policy that I took a stand against. I prayed about what to do. Pastors, let me ask, what would you do if someone in authority over you told you you could not pray in Jesus' name? What would you do in that kind of situation? Well, I decided what I was going to do. I was going to take a stand. And I was going to use whatever means I could through public awareness to bring attention to this bad Navy policy. I became a whistleblower. I put this policy on the front page of the Washington Times. And finally, I disobeyed the Navy policy. I called a press conference with Judge Roy Moore. Who knows the Ten Commandments, Judge, from Alabama? Yes. Well, Judge Roy Moore flew up to Washington and stood with me outside of the White House. And I called a press conference on a Thursday morning, and I prayed in Jesus' name in my full dress uniform on national television. I figure if they're going to punish chaplains who pray in Jesus' name, I want to be the first. I volunteer as a test case, and sure enough, I demanded my own court-martial. So it, sure enough, God bless the Navy brass, they granted my request. And it goes to a court-martial, and the judge, and the jury, and the prosecutor, and I'm on defense for my faith, and they had to decide, did he violate what they call a lawful order, or does the law actually protect chaplain's rights? Hi, this is Chaplain Klingenschmitt. I want to thank you for participating and watching this important message today about defending religious liberty. If there's anything our message proves, is that we can make a difference. If we will rise up together as the Church of Jesus Christ, we do not need to be ashamed of the name of Jesus. I need you to participate today in one of four ways. Please visit our website at PrayInJesusName.org. Again, that's PrayInJesusName.org, and sign our free petitions to defend religious liberty. Number two, I need you to call us at 866-OBEY-GOD, and you can sign what they call a fax petition. You don't have to know how to operate a fax machine, but for a nominal fee, we will fax your petition to all 100 senators or all 535 congressmen to defend the right to pray in Jesus' name. Number three, please purchase our DVDs and CDs with important teachings about defending religious liberty around the country. And number four, please donate. These rallies cost us thousands of dollars, and we need your donations to stay on the air. Please call us today at 866-OBEY-GOD and do what you can to help. Well, the Navy judge, Lewis Booker, wrote in his opinion that I violated a lawful order, that because of this new policy, SECNAV instruction 1730.7c, that public worship, everybody say public worship, is only safe inside of a Sunday chapel. That since I prayed on a Thursday morning outside the White House, that's not public worship, that's worshiping in public. And worshiping in public, he said, is not protected by federal law, can be punished as a misdemeanor crime if you do that in uniform. Guilty of worshiping in public in his uniform. That day in that Virginia Beach courtroom, tears of joy literally filled my eyes as I was finally found worthy to share in Christ's suffering and bear reproach for the name of Jesus Christ. I think God has a sense of humor because that same day, 14 September 2006, 1,000 miles off the Virginia coastline, Hurricane Gordon was swelling at full strength, and my first name is Gordon. Can you see God is laughing in heaven and getting glory out of this entire situation? Well, my story ran in 520 newspapers. It was taken up by 35 pro-family groups who submitted 300,000 petitions to Congress. 75 congressmen wrote to the president using my case as an example. And 85% of American citizens who were polled sided with us and wanted to defend the right to pray in Jesus' name. Hi, I'm Chaplain Klingenschmitt. I want to make available to you a very powerful teaching series that we put together just for you. This four-hour DVD has an amazing amount of information, and this 90-minute audio version on CD is a condensed version. You can have either one just by visiting our website at PrayInJesusName.org or calling us toll-free at 866-OBEY-GOD. In the first hour, we will tell you all about the revival that I saw at the Air Force Academy. In the second hour, we'll teach you about the importance of prayer and fasting and sanctification for this spiritual battle that we're all in. In the third hour, we'll tell you about the ministry of deliverance and even the miracles and exorcism stories that I saw when I was a Navy chaplain. In the fourth hour, we'll tell you about standing up for religious liberty, how I took a stand and faced my own court-martial, how we won the victory in Congress, 300,000 petition signers. Please visit our website, PrayInJesusName.org, or call us right now toll-free at 866-OBEY-GOD. These are important products for you and your church. God bless you in Jesus' name. So all this ended on the desk of Senator John Warner of Virginia. I met with Senator Warner's chief of staff a week after my court-martial, and I showed them all the documents. Here's the bad policy. Here's how the judge enforced it. Please, we've got all these people who want you to do something. What can you do? The very next night, Senator Warner made a speech on the floor of the Senate. Said, I, Senator John Warner, am being besieged by bloggers, emails, phone calls, faxes. Everyone wants to let chaplains pray in Jesus' name. And so we are ordering, by act of Congress, and thanks be to God, ladies and gentlemen, after my crucifixion came a resurrection. Because Congress ordered the Navy to reverse and rescind their bad policy, put the law back to the way it always was, and now all chaplains can pray in Jesus' name. Let's give God glory for that victory. Thank you, Jesus. Well, God bless the Navy lawyers. They refused to grandfather that victory back to my case. And so 4 months later, I was honorably discharged, but I lost a 16-year career. I lost $1 million pension, and my wife and I were evicted from our home on the Navy base. People ask me, "Chaps, that's a great price to pay, but was it worth it? Would you do it all over again?" And what do you think I tell them? Yes, I'd do it all over again because, Jesus, you are my witness. I never watered down my prayers, and you are more important to me than everything else this world has to offer. So what have I been doing since I got out the Navy? Well, that was about 3 years ago, my honorable discharge, and I have become a traveling evangelist. I have preached in 19 states. I've preached in over 70 churches, and I have found new Pharisees in the world to conquer because there are, unfortunately, people like Sue Herman of the ACLU, Barry Lynn of Americans United, and Gaylor of the Freedom From Religion Foundation, and Mikey Weinstein of the Militant Religion Foes Foundation, who go around the country threatening lawsuits to any city council, any state legislature, anyone who lets pastors use the word Jesus in public prayers. And this is a strange thing to me. We live in a country that celebrates the First Amendment, and yet there are some courts are letting them censor and silence the name of Jesus Christ. For example, I'm going to show you the 10 victories that we've had in the last 3 years. We fought, not only did we have a victory in the U.S. Congress, but around the country. For example, in Indiana, let's go with Judge David Hamilton, former lead attorney for the Indiana ACLU, became a judge, was appointed to the bench by President Clinton. And he ruled in Hendricks versus Bosma, the words Jesus or Christ or Savior are illegal words, cannot be uttered during a prayer if it's on the floor of the Indiana legislature. Meanwhile, he said that prayers to Allah are totally legal because that would never offend anybody. Well, my lawyers and I got involved. I work with the Rutherford Institute. We filed legal briefings to the Indiana Attorney General, who appealed the case. And the Seventh Circuit Court of Appeals, thanks be to God, 1 year later, they reversed his bad decision 2-1 and restored the right of pastors to use the word Jesus in their prayers in the Indiana legislature. Let's give God glory for that victory. Now, of course, this spring, President Obama nominated, guess who, as the first judge to be promoted to the Seventh Circuit Court of Appeals, Judge David Hamilton. So my organization, the Pray in Jesus Name Project, or PrayInJesusName.org, has organized a national petition campaign, and together we have put in over 700,000 faxes to the United States Senate to oppose and filibuster this judge, make sure he never gets promoted because of his anti-Jesus views. It's so important for you to sign petitions and to fax your congressman. We've made it very easy on our website. For a nominal fee, we will fax all 100 senators, and you don't have to know how to operate a fax machine. We put in, for example, 400,000 faxes against the hate crimes legislation and to protect the definition of marriage between one man and one woman. We put in over 300,000 faxes to the U.S. Congress to defend innocent life in the womb and make sure that abortion is not funded in this government health care program that they're coming up with. Hi, I'm Chaplain Klingenschmitt. I want to let you know about a powerful tool that we put together to help you communicate automatically with 535 congressmen or 100 senators all at one time. For a nominal fee, we will fax your signed petition to all of those people. You don't have to know how to operate a fax machine, but we will do the faxing on your behalf for a nominal fee. Just visit our website at PrayInJesusName.org or call us right now toll-free at 866-OBEY-GOD and sign our petition, especially to defend military chaplains who are still under fire sometimes for praying in Jesus' name. Congress has been trying to pass a bill, but they need to hear from the public. So we've made it automatic. Just sign our petition on our website or call us right now toll-free at 866-OBEY-GOD, and we will fax your petition to all 100 senators, all 535 congressmen. We've already sent hundreds of thousands of faxes on various issues, but now it's time for you to take a stand. Add your name to our petition today. God bless you in Jesus' name. Let's go to Ohio, where in the summer of 2007, the Speaker of the House, John Husted, Republican, censored the name of Jesus Christ from prayers offered by visiting pastors giving the invocation. Why would he do that? Because two Democrats, Chris Redfern and another, stood up and walked out in a huff because they were offended, easily offended, when a pastor prayed in Jesus' name. Well, with this ban in place in the Ohio legislature, I wasn't going to take that sitting down. I flew to Ohio. I preached in 11 days, I preached 18 times. We mobilized the pastors of Ohio to stand up together and petition the Ohio legislature. And guess what? As soon as they came back in session that fall, Speaker John Husted, his first act of business was to reverse the ban and let pastors pray in Jesus' name in the state of Ohio. Let's go to Florida. Chaplain Danny Harvey was fired as a Baptist pastor from Leesburg Regional Medical Center after 8 years working as a chaplain because he prayed in Jesus' name. They told him in writing, if you don't stop using the word Jesus in your prayers, we're going to fire you. Well, Chaplain Harvey remembers from the Bible, Colossians 3:17, whatever you do in word or deed, do it all in the name of the Lord Jesus. He didn't know how to water down his prayers. So he said, I can't do it, and they fired him the next day. Well, here Chaplain Harvey's out on the street telling his story. As soon as I heard in the newspapers, I bought a plane ticket to Florida. I flew down there with the local churches. We had 30 churches rally on the steps of City Hall. 1,200 citizens took a stand for Jesus and marched on City Hall, marched in a 3-mile-long parade around the hospital that fired him, and the CEO of the hospital resigned in the face of public scandal. There was a revival that day. They're still wearing the Jesus t-shirts from that rally in Leesburg, Florida, and 30 churches never agreed on anything before, but they all agree on the name of Jesus Christ. Let's go to Oklahoma, where there was a 20-year ban on Jesus prayers. And it was never really enforced until somebody complained. And so they enforced it, began excluding the pastors, and it made the newspapers. Reporter called me up, and here I am in the newspapers, activist vows to fight for Jesus' prayers. I flew to Oklahoma where we organized the pastors. The city council, I'm learning, they know how to count the noses of the people who show up to the city council meetings. When people flood and pastors flood with their congregations to attend City Hall and demand the right to pray in Jesus' name, they see the votes. And you know what the city council did? They voted 7-2 to reverse their ban, and now everyone in Oklahoma is free again to pray in Jesus' name. Thank you to God. Same thing on the left coast in Oregon. Would you believe, even out west, we have pro-Jesus pastors who care. And when the Baker City, Oregon City Council banned the name of Jesus because someone complained, I called the pastors. They mobilized wall-to-wall people attending a city council meeting, and the city council voted 5-0 to reverse the ban, let pastors pray in Jesus' name. In Virginia, where I spent my years as a Navy chaplain, we had a run-in last year with the governor of Virginia, Democrat Tim Kaine, because he and his police superintendent called all of their state trooper chaplains, all 17 of them, into a meeting, and the police chief gave them strict orders. At public ceremonies, you are not to use the word Jesus in your prayers. Well, 6 of the chaplains turned in their badge rather than deny Christ. These men are heroes who stood up for Jesus. Chaplain Mike Honecker and Chaplain Rex Carter. You can see me in the photo with them. I circulated a letter with American Family Association. We got 86 Virginia pastors to write to the governor. We had a press conference with 17 pastors. It was in the Washington Times, all over Virginia News. Why is the governor banning the name of Jesus from prayers? Governor Kane rejected our letter, and he said on television, "When I pray to God or the Lord, I can do that without mentioning Jesus."
It doesn't diminish my ability to worship my God, to pray to the Father or to Lord without mentioning Jesus Christ.
So all should my police chaplains pray the same way that I, the governor, pray? Well, I didn't think that was right. So we organized a rally outside the governor's mansion. Virginia, stand up for Jesus. We had the t-shirts. We brought in Matt Staver from Liberty Council as a guest speaker. And we prayed in Jesus' name, even if the governor did not want us to do that. The Virginia House, one delegate and one senator were at the rally, took up our cause, passed a bill through the House, 6630, to reinstate the six police chaplains. Let them pray in Jesus' name. But it was blocked in the Senate by some liberal Democrats, and unfortunately those police chaplains are not today reinstated. But I'll talk more about that in a few minutes. By the way, if you want to sign a petition for those police chaplains or for any of these issues, we have petitions available for electronic. It's free. Just go to prayinjesusname.org and add your name, and we will move mountains together with those petitions, I believe. In Maryland, would you believe the ACLU is threatening to sue Annapolis, the Naval Academy, to end their nearly 200-year-old tradition since 1845 of allowing midshipmen to pray with the chaplain during the noon meal? They've been doing this forever, but now suddenly somebody's offended and the ACLU is threatening a lawsuit. Well, we mobilized a petition drive through our direct mail campaign, and thanks be to God now, the Navy is still defending the rights of midshipmen to pray before their meals. Hi, I'm Chaplain Klingenschmitt. Can I take a moment to ask you to donate today? There are such important battles that we're fighting and winning around the country to defend religious liberty. How much is the right to pray in Jesus' name worth to you? Well, to me, it was worth a 16-year career and $1 million pension, which I sacrificed to defend Jesus Christ. I'm asking you to call us today, toll-free at 866-OBEY-GOD, and make a donation. How much would you pay to defend religious liberty? Would you give $10 or $20 or $100? I bet there's some people who are watching who can even give $1,000 today just to help us stay on the air, to broadcast this into people's homes, to organize these petition drives, and especially, we spend thousands of dollars organizing rallies around the country and petitioning legislators. Please call us today at 866-OBEY-GOD and give the best pledge that you can give to defend religious liberty and take a stand for Jesus Christ. We can't do it without you. Please donate today. In Pennsylvania, the Speaker of the House, Keith McCall, this is this year, issued a brand new policy that pastors cannot use the word Jesus in their prayers. He's afraid of a lawsuit by the atheist complainers at Americans United, who wrote him a nasty letter, said, "We're going to sue you if you don't allow, if you don't forbid and ban Jesus prayers." Well, they're on one side of the teeter-totter, right? I'm on the other side of the teeter-totter and saying, I'm going to mobilize pastors to vote you out of office if you don't protect the right to pray in Jesus' name. So the speaker is making up his mind, who do I go with? Do I get sued or do I get voted out of office? What am I going to do here? And he censors Pastor Jerry Stoltzfus, was literally disinvited to say the prayer because when he submitted a prayer ahead of time, it included the illegal word Jesus, and so they said, no, you can't pray. I organized an email petition campaign, and we put in 100,000 faxes to the Pennsylvania legislature. They had never seen so much paper on their floor when they came in to work, those blessed delegates of Pennsylvania. And you know what happened? The speaker reversed his ban, apologized to the pastor, and said, I'm no longer going to pre-screen the prayers. Pastors in Pennsylvania are free again to pray in Jesus' name. Same thing in Lodi, California. we had a ban because the Freedom From Religion Foundation banned the name of Jesus. So we organized a petition. The mayor refused to let the chaplains pray in Jesus' name, the visiting pastors. We organized a rally, 400 pastors. But no, the mayor would not change his vote. Finally, we vowed to publish billboards outside of Lodi, California. We're going to list the names of the city councilors who vote against Jesus. The mayor changed his vote. And now everybody can pray in Jesus' name in Lodi, California. I just flew in from Virginia this morning, and some of you may have read the newspapers, that we just had an election in Virginia. And I want to point out a couple of the key figures in this election. You'll see that Cray Deeds, the Democrat, wanted to be the governor of Virginia, but he was one of the senators who voted against prayers in Jesus' name for the police chaplain problem. Meanwhile, you have the pro-Jesus Attorney General, Republican Bob McDonnell, who defended the legislation, said, "I want to let chaplains pray in Jesus' name." So I took that information, I'm scratching my head, thinking, how can I really impact this election? And I made a voter guide, and 5 weeks ago, I faxed it to 2,000 Virginia pastors. Not only, by the way, the score at that time was about 48-43. They were drawing even in the polls. But since that time, the pro-Jesus Republican pulled away, and now we have a new governor of Virginia. Bob McDonnell is going to reinstate those police chaplains. Here I am in the corner. I got my photo with the governor-elect the other day. We presented to him our perhaps 15,000 petitions now. And we also got rid of six of those delegates who voted against Jesus prayers in this election. So thank God for that. We need pastors to get involved. We need people to sign these petitions at PrayInJesusName.org and take back our country. God bless you and thank you for your time in Jesus' name.
Thank you for watching this important message. Chaplain Klingenschmitt needs your help to defend religious liberty today, right now. So please pick up your phone and call us toll-free at 866-OBEY-GOD to add your name to our petition to Congress to defend the rights of military chaplains to pray publicly in Jesus' name. For a nominal fee, we will fax your petition to all 100 senators and 435 representatives. We need your donations, large or small, to defend religious liberty, to organize rallies and petitions, and to stay on the air and continue these important broadcasts. Chaplain Klingenschmitt sacrificed his 16-year career and $1 million pension for Jesus' name. So how much can you give today? You can also get the chaplain's important teaching series on DVD or CD today just by calling us toll-free at 866-OBEY-GOD or on his website, PrayInJesusName.org. Sign up to receive our free weekly email and follow Chaps on Facebook and Twitter. Please mail your best donation to Pray in Jesus' Name, P.O. Box 77077, Colorado Springs, Colorado 80970. Call us toll-free right now at 866-OBEY-GOD. God bless you. In Jesus' name.